Church of God, located at 4601 South Jackson Boulevard, Chicago, Illinois, where the pastor is Elder Ricky Dukes.
Soul that's tired, God, there's a soul that's hunger. There's a soul that's tired, wants something better, God. And God, we pray you'll travel the airwaves. God, we pray the Holy Spirit will go to hotels. And God, you go to bedrooms. And God, now driving down the street, the Holy Ghost will arrest people, pull them over. And may they cry for the death of their soul. What must I do to be saved? God bless the man of God who's standing in the gap this afternoon, dear God. And God, is there a time, God, we need to hear your word? God, we need it now. God, the people are confused. The people are hurting, God. And God, we pray you would heal the land. Heal the souls of men. And God, we're certainly grateful for it because your great name is worthy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. At this time, let's receive the arm sandwich with a hearty amen.
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 Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank the Lord. It's good to be here.
Amen.
And as he said, it's gospel time. Time for the gospel. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. We're doing some serious work here. We've heard this before, that time is winding up. But I'm afraid this spirit that's super prevalent in the world tells us not so. That's my burden, is on this spirit of unbelief. Let me tell you something. God is trying to get our attention. Brother, I get awakened in the middle of the night. God says, hey, man, listen. Spirit of unbelief is all over the place. Hey, get up, get up. Hey, write this down. Write this down. Say this. Write the word. Now I'm telling you what. Listen, listen. The spirit of unbelief said there ain't nothing to no Jesus coming. Ain't no Jesus coming back. Man, how long have you all been saying that? Come on now. Come on. Man, ain't none of this happening. You all been talking hell and all. Man, ain't none of this happening. We're not understanding that the Bible says because God's mercy, he's not willing that anybody would perish, but that all would come to repentance. So he's tarrying. The Bible says he's long-suffering with us. You know what that means? He's putting up with us. Because he don't want to call him. He's looking and says, too many. Too many's going. If I call him now, too many's going to hell. Too many. And we take it as, oh, ain't nothing to it. Ain't nothing really happening. So I'm going to go ahead and do what I want to do. Brother, they wrote a song, one of the gospel groups back in the day. They don't write like this anymore. But the song went like this. It said, the devil told Eve she could eat from the tree. She wouldn't surely die. She told Adam, it's all right. So they both took a bite and lost their lives. Says, Carol, you know this song, don't you? Now he tells you, do what you want to do. God will understand. So now you feel justified to do your thing on the side and still say amen. Don't you really see me? That's where they used to write. I'm going to tell you, the spirit of unbelief, man. Man, it's wearing people out, man. And no more belief. We talk to young people, brother. We used to be able to say, don't you remember Moses? They don't know nothing about it. They don't even get taught. They don't know nothing about it. Their minds are open to what the world has offered. And that's why you see so many people. And the fault is not just the young people. It's generations before them who have failed and been hypocrites. And now the young people don't want to have nothing to do with church. But thank God there are the people who refuse the hypocrite. And if we see it, we'll call it. Isn't that right, Saints?
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen. Please bear with me this morning. I'm like a doctor. You know, back in the day, you know, 40 years or so ago, you know, people would go to the doctor and they may have gotten, you know, they'll look and they say, oh man, this person has, you know, no liver cancer, right? And then the doctors wouldn't tell you everything. You remember those old days? They wouldn't tell you everything. And then what happened is, see, I'm going to show you why today you hear so much when you go to the doctor. What happened is people start suing the doctors and tell them, you didn't tell me everything. I could have done this and this and this, so I'm suing you for not telling me everything. So now you go to the doctor, they go, listen, I'm going to run it down to you. Your enzymes are up and this is down and the liver can, you got 6 months. Oh, are you trying to scare me? No, I'm not. I'm trying not to be sued again. You all told us you weren't saying everything. So I'm going to tell you everything. That's my job this morning. I'm going to tell you everything. I'm going to tell you what's real. We don't do x-rays. We don't do all type of diagnostics. And when we're done, that's you. No fear. I'm just going to call it like it is. help us. This spirit of unbelief is wearing us out. I'm sitting here. I had a person who was real close to me die, brother. And they had a disease, and my medical knowledge started kicking in. I said, stage one, this is going to happen. Look, there it is. I was like, man, I don't want to see it. Now, by the time this happened, this is going to kick in. You look at it, you see it happen. You want to get rid of your knowledge because you don't want to see the stages. You see it happening.
My God.
I'm sitting here spiritually doing the same thing. Man, look, bro, we're going down. And people are listening. Man, we go. Those who are in touch with the Lord, we can easily look out here and tell. All of you are doctors who say, all of you.
Amen.
Looking and diagnosed to see the signs and the symptoms that we're going down. Not the states ain't going up, it's going down. Hello? We're going down. Not up. Let me tell you. You better build your hope on things eternal. This stuff right here is about done. Let me show you something. God help me. I don't know how I'm going to do this. I got too much. The first time we dealt with this unbelief, we walked us through the scripture. Amen. We showed how unbelief is wearing people out. Is that right, saints?
Yeah.
We showed how in the book of Romans, amen, we showed how the Jews, brother, they received the word from God. They said, hey, Moses, listen. Man, listen. We hear what you're saying, but let us hear from God. And so he said, okay. Listen, you're going to have to sanctify yourselves for 3 days and all of this and all this. And God is going to come to the mountain and he's going to talk to you. Is that right, saints? You going with me?
Yeah.
And then, just like they said, he came down and said, listen. They're like, Moses, we don't want to hear from him no more. We tell you what. You talk to him. You come tell us what he said. And that's what we'll do. And then you know what they did? They disobeyed. People don't want to hear. This spirit of unbelief will have us leave here and go somewhere, brother, a hypocrite with a capital H.
My God.
Because we don't believe anymore. Much unbelief. He said, listen, if you die like that, you'll have your portion with the unbelievers. But Lord, I've been to church, but you're an unbeliever.
My God.
Let me show you how, let me get to it so you all can see how we're going down here. And let me tell you something. I've been feeling impressed. Go to Habakkuk. I was going to read this a little bit later. But let's go to this book. Let me tell you what I'm doing here. I'm not here to say these words because it's time, at this time slot, it's time for the preaching to occur.
Right.
That's not why I'm here. I go sit down for that.
Right.
No, bro. God give us specific stuff to tell you. And he gave me, listen, I don't know why I wasn't able to deal with it. I dealt with part one about 3 or 4 weeks ago. I don't know why God waited this long to say, okay, now do part two.
All right, brother.
Listen, I'm my hands off this, man. God, let God be true and let everybody else be alive. I want to show you something here. In the book of Habakkuk, we're going to go to the second chapter, but I want to set this up. This man was walking around. He was a prophet, brother. He was walking around wondering, God, wait, hold up, God. I got some questions for you.
All right.
Why are you allowing such evil to occur in the land? Mm-hmm. Lord, why did you allow your people to get caught in Babylon and get enslaved? What, Lord, why'd you do that? And God said, listen, Lord, you've been saying you're going to do this and this and this is going to happen, but we ain't seen it yet, Lord. What's going on, God? It's the same questions that people are saying right now.
Yeah.
I've been hearing about this for so long. Okay, let's go. Let's see if this is the same. Let's go to the second chapter, starting at verse 1.
I will stand upon my watch.
He said, listen, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. God said he's going to do something. So what I'll do is I'll stand. This is literally what he said. God's been saying he's going to do some things. It ain't happened yet. But I believe God. So I'm going to stand on my watch. This is literally what he's saying. Come on.
And set me upon the tower.
I'm going to set up on the tower.
And will watch to see what he will say unto me.
I'm going to see what God. I'm going to ask him a series of questions. And ain't nothing happened yet. I'm going to see what God's going to say to me.
Okay.
Come on.
And what I shall answer when I am reproved.
When I'm reproved, I'll see what I'll say to God. Come on.
And the Lord answered me and
said, then all heaven, God said, oh yeah, you want to meet me, huh? God came and said, okay. He said, then the Lord answered me. What?
Write the vision.
I'm going to show you some stuff. And I want you to write it down, man. Come on.
And to make it plain.
I don't want no high-suited words. Make it real easy for people to understand.
Yes, sir.
Write it plain. Come on.
That he may run that we
that the one, whoever God is talking to, when they hear it, they will run for the saving of their soul. Man, this world is offering anything that's got a name. And trying to, those who are saved, right? These folks, come on back out. Come on back out here. Am I right? He's offering all types of stuff. Man, and what?
For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
He said, listen. This is God talking to him. I know it ain't happened yet.
Yes, sir.
But the vision, it is for a certain time. And what?
But at the end, it shall speak.
Oh, listen. God said, but listen. Don't be in a hurry. Because at the end, that vision that you saw, oh, it's going to talk. And it's going to talk loud and long. It's going to be real plain. Come on.
And not lie.
What?
And not lie.
It will not lie. Come on.
Though it tarry.
Though, listen, that's mercy. The Bible says, though it tarry. For those who don't know what tarry means, it's just simply waiting. Though it's holding off.
Amen.
Though it's holding off. What?
Wait for it.
Just sit back. See, those who are saved, Brother Ben, sometimes, Lord, we go, Lord, come on back, Jesus.
My God.
Lord, it's too much going on. Come back. God says, stop that. No. Because there's too many that's not right. There's too many that's not saved. What I need you to do is pray. I give you grace to wait.
All right, brother.
Those who say, I'm telling you, though, the devil talk about going back to the world. Ain't no time to be entertaining that type of thought. Am I right now? Ain't no time to be entertaining that type of thought. Man, listen, people leave, they don't get back for the most part. I didn't say they don't go to church. I said they don't get back. They'll get back to God for the most part. They'll get back to truth for the most part. Oh, they'll go to church. You think the devil is, you can't reason with the devil. Man, he'll have you the biggest church door ever. Please. Man, with the knowledge we get here, you'll go out there and all you got to do is say a few words. That's it. We perceive that you're a preacher. You're a preacher. Oh, God's anointing is all.
Sure.
And I'll have you up on the stage and occupy you. Lock the devil. Click. It's too legit to quit now, man. Lock you in. We'll pay you. We'll pay you. That's what the Revelator said. Didn't it? They'll give gifts. They'll give gifts, brother. They give gifts. Babylon. False religion. These churches out here that's not in the Bible. He said they'll occupy you and they'll give you gifts. They'll lock you in. Lord, help us. Unbelief. Verse 3, read it again. He says what?
For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
It's just, it's ill, but believe me. The time that God, keep your finger there. Let's come back to this one. God help me. I don't know what sequence God will do this in, but let's go to 2 Peter. I want to show you something. Please keep your finger there, because I want to read that verse after we do this. Let's see if we can make it make more sense. 2 Peter 3. What's the Bible say? Starting at verse number 1, please.
This second epistle, beloved.
Epistle is none but a letter.
Yes,
this is just the second letter that Peter is writing. This second letter, beloved.
I write now unto
I'm
you.
I write to you.
In both which I stir up your pure
minds. I
want to
stir up your pure minds.
I live remembrance.
Now, I want to stir up your pure minds. Those who are living right, your pure minds. Yes. By way of remembrance. What?
That he may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets.
Yeah.
And of the commandments of
God. That we be mindful of the words that we just got through reading. That were spoken by the holy prophets. Come on.
And of the commandments of us.
Yes.
The apostles and us, of the Savior.
And of this nation right here that you heard what we said. You'll be in remembrance of this. Come on.
Knowing this first.
What?
That there shall come in the last days.
Slow down. There come when?
In the last days.
But man, you all been saying that for a long time. Oh, the vision is for a particular. God showed mercy. I'm going to show you here. We're going to see it. He said, when now?
There shall come in the last days.
What?
Scoffers.
Scoffers. You know what scoffers are? People who are hard to get along with. They got something negative to say about all type of stuff. Every time somebody trying something good, they want to speak negatively on the gospel, on the way we live. Man, how y'all living like that? What are you doing? And look, I've actually seen where parents, maybe their son or daughter is real wild, being used up. They run into the gospel. They get saved. And the parents go, what you doing? The time I get saved, what you doing? I've seen it. Your child's in better shape now. Yes, oh, I don't want them living there. What you doing? Huh? I said I've seen it. Last days. Scoffers. People say stuff like this. I want to dispel the myth. People say the last days, you're not going to be able to tell the winter from the summer. Go outside. You will come in and say it's February. You can tell. That ain't in nobody's body. That's not in the Bible. That's somebody came up with that. But I tell you what will happen in the last days. There'll be scoffers. What did the Bible say?
Walking after their own
lusts. Doing their own thing. Listen. Almost everything you tell them. Do your thing. It's you. Live your best life. Oh, yeah, what you feel? Oh, do what you feel. What you feeling, girl? It's all about you. Forget the Lord. Was he happy or like, no, man, I'm not going to be bound by that. Listen, you're thinking, you're talking to me, telling me you ain't going to be bound by what I'm saying. I ain't got nothing to do with it. It's the word of God, brother. Come on.
And saying,
what?
Where is the promise of his coming?
Isn't it the same thing? Back then, they asked the Becca, man, listen, when is the vision going to happen? And God said, listen, Brother Jason, oh, the vision is going to happen, but it's at an appointed time. What I'm doing is holding on. For a reason. Amen. Now right here, what does the scripture say? Ain't nothing new. What does it say again?
Where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the age.
Ain't nothing happened yet.
That's what they say.
Unbelief tells you, listen, man, ain't nothing happened. Do your thing. You ain't going to get caught. Do you know that the devil is going to hell? Didn't nobody say that? So he will do whatever he can to disguise himself. Can you? I got your finger on one scripture, right, my sister? Can I keep your finger on that one too? Can we turn to another one? My God, help us. 2 Corinthians 11.
God bless you, brother.
Lord, help us. I want to make this real plain. God, that who reads and who see the vision will run,
yes, sir,
to the saving of their life. Lord, help us. So let's start here. Let's start at verse 12, please. 11 and 12. Take Corinthians 11. Let's go to verse number 12, please.
But what I do, that I will do,
yep,
that I may cut off occasion from them which desire occasion, that wherein they glory, they may be found even as we.
Come on.
For such are false apostles.
Well, listen to this. Such are false apostles.
Deceitful workers.
Talking about people that's mimicking the people of God. Right. False apostles. That's why these churches, brother, they're so packed. Because, bro, listen, they ain't teaching nothing.
Right.
You can do that. Listen, they actually have parties in church.
Right. Yeah.
They play secular music in church. You don't ever see that on YouTube?
Yes.
Listen, they don't even know that happened before. Not the exact same thing, but in God. Go with me spiritually speaking. In the Old Testament, Jesus said, didn't he say, Daniel, brother, when you'll see the abomination that brings desolation. So one king took them over, and he took the altar. And he moved the rightful thing, and brother, he put some pork up there and offered a sacrifice on God's altar. Pork. Unclean. In God's temple. This is what these churches are doing. And Jesus said, when you see the abomination that brings desolation, they don't know they were left empty. Standing in the holy place, brother. This is where we are.
Yes.
We've seen all types of abomination.
Yes.
And it's bringing all types of desolation.
Yes.
Brother Bo is asleep. And we don't believe it. Why do you think they can do that? Why do you think you can have worldly music, Al Green, blasting in your church? I'm not, let's see those from the 70s. Yeah, we don't know. Yeah, yeah, I see you trying. I know you don't want to dance, but you know you want to get on up. They're forcing people to sing. All right, how about the 80s? Yeah, feet don't feel. Yeah, come on now, let's go. In the church house, brother. Unbelief. The covers are off. There are no limits. Listen, it's on now. And we're going down. Come on.
For such are false apostles.
Yes.
Deceitful workers.
Deceitful workers.
Transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ.
See how they do the deceitful work? They transform. The devil don't care. He will disguise himself. I told you he's going to hell. Y'all hear me when I say that? And you know what they say about misery. He will take every last one of us with him. So he will disguise and do whatever he got to do to get your attention. Let me tell you something. Don't talk to him.
Amen.
Listen. I told some people about a person who I know. Well, they got paid. They went to the currency exchange, bro. And they had their money in their pocket. And a person, the guy just walked up. Hey, listen. Let me talk to you. You know, so blah, 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 blah. Person I know very well. They got home, brother. They reached in their pocket. They had paper in their pocket. They were like, what's this? All type of paper. The money was gone, replaced with paper.
My God.
Talking to the person.
My God.
Con man. Confidence. That's what that word means. Confidence. Confidence man. Devil just wants you to talk to him. Just yo. Let's just talk. I ain't gonna let you do that. Let's just talk. I told you before about that old Alfred Hitchcock movie where the devil, he was talking to this guy all movie long. Listen, let me have your soul, I'll let you live forever.
Wow.
And all movie long, he was doing things to this guy. He was talking to the guy. And the guy was like, no, man, no. And the devil was like, listen, give me your soul. How about it, man? I'll let you live forever.
Right.
Think about it. No more sickness, all that. I'll let you live forever. Eventually, the man gave him, okay, devil. Here's my soul. The devil's like, okay, yeah, you'll never die. Set the man up for murder. They put him in jail. Boom, bam, in jail. You can't reason with no devil, brother. Had the man put in jail for life. You can't reason with the devil. I'm trying to wake us up here. Let's keep reading.
Verse 14.
Yeah.
And no marvel.
No marvel.
Satan,
you know about these false preachers? He's talking about false preachers. One tell you can still sin and go to heaven. They're false.
Yeah.
You know where they get their power from? Let's read that again. He says what?
For such are false apostles.
Yes.
Deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of
Christ.
They
try to act like God's preachers. Come on.
And no marvel.
No marvel.
For Satan himself.
Because Satan himself
is transformed into an angel of light.
The devil didn't say, you know what? If you ain't careful, I'm going to transform on you.
All right.
No. He didn't say that. What's the Bible say? Read that again.
And no marvel.
Yes.
For Satan himself.
What?
Is transformed. Into an angel.
How are you going to be able to tell the truth from error without God? You can't do it by being a church goer without living right. Just deceived as everybody else. You can't tell no difference. I take the Holy Ghost to tell you the difference if that man or that woman is true or not. That's why God want to help us out, even in marriage. They want to help us. Marry the right person because you mess around out there and you got them, you marry the wrong person. Then you all go to the house. The person. Yeah, this is what I really am. Oh, you said I do. And for years you messed up. Brother Walt, help me, brother. He's trying to help us in all aspects of our life. And then when we leave, because we all are leaving here, help us on the other side. He's trying to. God help us. But unbelief, man, it's telling us, man, this ain't nothing to it. Don't you know? his mind. Let the fight. Listen, the devil keep following you. Keep up. You can't be sitting back taking, letting him smack you around. You got to get up. Lord, I got to fast. I got to pray. I'm not going to sit here and let him just keep following my mind. No, sir. No, sir. It's like he said, listen, don't you know that the Bible says the devil knows he has but a short time. Did you know the Bible said that? He has but a short time. So what did he do? He's been trying all type of stuff. So in these last days, brother, he unleashed this major one. He's like, come here, boy.
My God.
Come here, unbeliever. Come here, boy. Come here, boy. Come here, unbeliever. Get him! Get him! Man, he's unleashed. I'm going to show you how we're going down. I'm going to show you. My God, help us. Help us, Lord. So the devil is transformed. Let's go back to where we were. Where we were in Peter?
Yes.
Second Peter, let's go back there.
Chapter 3.
Yes.
Verse number 5.
Verse 5 says what?
For this they willingly are ignorant.
So people are willingly ignorant. Lord, I don't want to hear. No. We've already heard it. And now we're responsible. You'll say, well, I only know that much. And Sister Carly, you know that much. Guess what? She's got to have that 100%. You got to have that 100%. No matter how much you know, it's what you know. And we all got to bring it home. Isn't that right? Willingly ignorant of. Come on.
That by the word of God, the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water. Whereby the world that then was, being overflowed with water, perished.
Now, people don't even believe that the flood happened. Let me show you something. I'll close the Bible and I'll show you scientifically that was a major flood on earth. Do you know that there's more physical evidence in the scientific studies of a major flood than anything else? God trying to, he leave the tables. He left the water on the tables. You can see it marked and marked and marked. And you can tell, as you dig down the certain animals that are in there, the certain fossils, you can tie those. Go, oh, yeah. He tried to leave it on record. Maybe they'll believe this. Maybe I can get through them through the natural record. People still don't believe it. He showed them scientific. Brother, you do the studies. Let me get my carbon 14 dating out. Let me see that. Yeah, man. For some reason, and this is what happened. They try to time it. Well, about 4 billion years ago. For some reason, after about 10,000 years, the carbon 14 dating falls apart. Who might have heard? Let's think about that. Hello, let's think about the velocity of decay of carbon. Right. No! That's because that's when it started! But they're trying to do some other stuff.
Right.
That's why they got all these probes going out to space trying to tell people, oh, this is when the new birth. No! No, no, no. God has spoken. Now we know. But unbelief tells us, and none of this stuff happened. Let's go.
Verse 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same world, are kept in store.
Let me show you this. Can't take me slow here. The heavens and the earth that you and I see right now. Y'all see me? Y'all with me? The ones that are right now. Watch this. What? The word that said, flood it out, is the same word that said, wait. The heaven and earth that you're messing right now, that same word is saying, hold off. Let's see. Come on.
Are kept in store.
They're kept in store.
Reserved. Unto the fire.
Yes.
Against the day of judgment and perdition.
Oh, but the
ungodly.
The vision that is planned is going to happen. Read it.
But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing.
Let me show you something. I'm going to give you a little characteristic of God. I want you all to please be with me. See, Sister Tanya, we're the ones in a hurry because God gave us this stuff all the time.
Yeah.
But when you're talking about God, your smartphones, your watches, your Apple watches, take all this stuff off.
Right.
None of that's relevant. Let me show you what the Bible says. It's a characteristic of God. What did he say?
But beloved,
yes.
Be not ignorant of this.
Don't be ignorant of this.
The one that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years.
Read it again.
But beloved,
yes.
Be not ignorant of this one
watch
day.
Watch this.
That one day.
Watch this. One day.
Is with the Lord.
Wait, one day, 24 hours, that's what we time. It's with God. What?
As 1,000 years.
That's 1,000 years. God's like, hey, day, 1,000 years, whatever. Take it or leave, whatever. But wait a minute, then again, what?
and 1,000 years as one day.
See, we're the ones in this time. God said, that stuff is irrelevant to me. Lord, how come you haven't pulled the trigger? You've been talking about Jesus coming back. God was like, I'm the one who, look, I carved this stuff called time out for you.
Yes, sir.
I live in eternity. Don't you dare call, don't try to hold me to the same standard. Man, I call it, I already said it's going to happen. So God is going on doing his thing. That word that he spoke, brother, is still marching. Here's the coming of Jesus right here. God has been done because he already called it. That's when it's happening. He ain't standing there watching no clock. But guess what? We're all marching right to it. Oh Lord, can you wait? Time is like, what's that mean? Boy, wait, give me a moment. Time is like, what's that mean? I don't know what wait means. I don't know what that means. Time, I don't know what you mean. Talk about some weight.
Oh, sir.
Hold up, Lord. I ain't ready. But what's time? Like, I don't know what that means. I'm still going. This day right here that I've marked, I said the vision is coming. Oh, it's coming. Sir. Unbelief says, no, it ain't. You've been saying that, Brother John, for a long time. I heard you talking about Jesus coming back. I heard your brother say it. I heard your mom say it. Right. You've been saying it for a long time. Ain't nothing happened yet.
My God.
The last days. Now, go back to Hebrews. Let me show you something. I'm sorry. I'm about to leave the verse 9 out. We got to deal with
verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise.
The issue is this. You know why it's waiting? Don't get it mixed up. God is not slack concerning his promise. He said, listen, I am going to all time. Everybody's going to stand in the judgment. If you're right, you're going to heaven. If you got little sin in your life, hell is your home. Oh, God is too good for that. Oh, he won't put anybody. That's what unbelief is all about. Verse 9 says, watch, check this out.
The Lord is not slack concerning his promise.
See, now, today, these churches, they'll just read that part. They'll just read that part. God's not slack. Oh, then he promised he's going to give you a car. Oh, he's going to promise to build your bank. Oh, God is not slack. That's all they want to talk about is your prosperity. No, that ain't what this scripture talks about at all. Okay? God is not slack concerning his promises. Come on.
And some men
as people count slack. Lord, you've been saying it for a long time. That's how men count. Okay? When you gonna get them? When you gonna get them? That's how men count. But that's not how God is. Come on.
But he is long-suffering to us.
But what it is that he's long-suffering to us. What does that mean? He puts up with us. He's slow down. Listen, I'm telling you all, God is trying to help us. But he's like, look, if I call it now, look at the millions going to hell. We don't believe that either. Do you know we don't believe that? Turn to Isaiah 5:14. Keep your finger there. We don't believe that. We're coming right back to this to finish this verse out. We don't believe that God has sent people to hell in the throne. It's not God's wish at all. But he put in place the requirements. People want to do it another way. They don't want to come to God's requirements. So guess what? If I don't want to come God's way, it's only another one. God's like, come on, man, come on. He said, come let us reason. Don't you notice in the Bible? He said, listen, can we reason? Can we talk? Man, I don't want you going to hell. Well, God, I don't want to do that. I don't want to be. So, well, what does the Bible say in Isaiah 5:14?
Therefore, hell hath enlarged herself and opened her mouth without measure. And their glory and their multitude and their pomp and he that rejoiceth shall descend into it.
The Bible says hell has enlarged herself. Hell has boundaries that move. Because people are just disobedient. And then hell is like, I can't accommodate all this. I can't accommodate all that disbelief. All that disobedience. That will be said, hell has enlarged itself without measure. God help us. Lord, would you get to our heads? God help us. Precious souls, God don't want anybody going to hell. But the spirit of unbelief, I'm trying to wake us up to it. God help us. Let's finish Rebecca, the second. Let's go to to verse 3, and then I'm going to show you, share something with you, show you what's going on today.
For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Now, after all that I said, we come back to this. It's not that the vision is not going to happen, but it's for a set time. And God is trying to show mercy. My God, help us. Come on, my sister.
But at the end, it shall speak, and not
at the end of it, though, it is going to speak, and it will be accurate. It will not lie. Come on.
Though it tarry.
No, it's waiting. We understand it now, don't we understand why it's waiting now? God's trying to show mercy. So he's holding it off. Come on.
Though it tarry, wait for it.
Wait for it.
Because it will surely come.
It will surely come.
It will not tarry.
It is going to get to a point where it will no longer tarry. Let me show you something. As we sit here and reject God, I dealt with that last time in Mark 1. We sat here and we have successfully kicked God out of our homes. Kicked them out of the schools. Kicked them out of work.
My God.
Just kicked them out of the life. Wait, I'm not done yet. Kick them out of church.
My God.
That's why people can do what they want to do. And they tell you to do that, but do it as long as you bring your tithes. You don't have a false religion, man. They got people guarding the doors and stuff. Oh, what a fellowship. Come on, you bring your monies. One preacher saw a person in a grocery store, and the person said, hey, man, I haven't seen your church for a while. Yeah, I'm sorry, Pastor. That's all right, Bones. Just send your tithes. You can go to hell, just send your tithes. This vision that we've been talking about, it's going to happen. It's going to be accurate, and one day it's going to be over. Let me show you something. Let me share something with you. God said be fruitful and multiply, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
Didn't he say replenish earth?
Yes.
Can I share something with you? Did you know that right here in the good old U.S. of A, we rejected God so much that we said, forget having babies. We need to have 2,100 babies per 1,000 women in order to replace the population that's dying, blah, 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 blah. You got me? How many did I say? We need to have 2,100 per 1,000 women. So that's a little over 2 babies per person, right? Do you know that 58 states are below that? Only 2 states are doing it? Let me show you something. Overall in the United States.
Yes.
You say, what's this got to do with this? Let me give you, see. There are about 1,700 babies born per 1,000 women. That's in the negative. Guess what's happening to our population, everyone? They disbelieve God. They don't want to be married. Homosexuality is on the rise. So guess what? You can't have babies being homosexual.
Oh, sir.
I got to borrow from somebody. Listen. People say, listen, it's my body. I'm not having a baby. True enough. It is the woman's body. True enough. But God said, I want you to have babies. It's okay. We rejected God. No problem. Guess what? Our numbers of having babies going down. Guess what? We're not replacing the population. Guess what that does in the long run?
Right.
Your country is in trouble.
Yes.
The CDC and all who are studying this, they said, we admit this is trouble. You know what? Economically, you will go down because you don't have people to work.
Yes.
And God was like, hello, hello, I'm here. I've been trying to tell you.
Wow.
Yeah. But abortion doesn't give you live babies. No. And partial birth abortion is of the devil. All abortion is. But I told some of my scientist friends at work, I said, they said, ain't nothing wrong with partial birth abortion. I said, do you know the process? They said, well, I think so. I said, do you know it? Well, I'm not sure. I said, let me walk you through the steps, though. 1, 2, 3, 4, kill. What? I didn't know that's what they did. Oh, yeah, they partially abort the baby, keep their head in, take the forceps, snap the back of their neck, suck the brain out, and kill that baby who could be 9 months old. Harry. That's straight up murder. But when God is not here, what's your conscience like? When God is not here, I only hear God. pay for our decisions. Pay for it now. I told you time to pay is up. It's here now. So I talked last time about what it is. Now I'm going to deal with the results of it. That's one of them. Our population is dropping for so many reasons. You don't turn that around on the dime. How about marriage?
Come on.
Oh, man, marriage is like taboo almost now. People say, listen, I ain't getting married. We can do everything we want to do. That's what people, we do everything we want to do, and I ain't getting married. You have your account, I have my account. I keep everything separate. So some people going into relationships with one foot, but, you know, at least in our day, man, you have to win something. You have to show something. Brother, Jesus, help us. Help us, Lord. We're going down and don't even see it. The number of STDs, sexually transmitted diseases, is skyrocketing. Guess what? Those of us on the medical side, my sister Jackie, we're losing the battle. Our antibiotics are not working like they used to. Man, we got some super stuff out here now. Stuff used to treat all the time, gonorrhea and syphilis and all that. We said, now, you hit them with the medicine. Boom, that should do it. Uh-oh. Hit them with another. Boom, that should do it. Oh, they got the super bug. Another reason why the birth weight is dropping. See, a lot of times women can have it and they have no symptoms. Then you get married. You go, let's have a baby. And the doctor goes, oh, you have PID. Have a laboratory. Say, I know. What was it? Oh, you have I never do it. That destroys your ability to have a baby. No, it's, no, we're paying for it now. Oh, we're paying for it now. No, we kicked God out. No, Lord, sugar. He said, I tried to show mercy before y'all kicked me out. And at the same time, Jesus is coming back. Man, unbelievable. Man, we don't believe it. We don't believe it. So we keep doing it. God help us. Jesus is standing here saying, I just said a lot more. I'm going to let the Holy Ghost speak here. I'm done. Jesus is saying, I'm trying to help you. You're trapped with the spirit of unbelief. I sent this man to tell you that so that you can see. Can you step back? Sometimes you have to be able to tell, man, every time I eat so-and-so, my stomach hurts. Sometimes you got to be able to tell for yourself, this makes me sick. So how do I get out of it? I got to make sure I stop eating that stuff. Right? You all know what I'm talking about? Sometimes God, he'll deal with us like this and say, listen, you've been having these signs and symptoms for a long time. The spirit of unbelief has got you. You no longer believe. But I'm trying to show you through this man up there. I ain't nothing but a vessel. You don't even need to know my name. Just know the word of God. That's just nothing but a vessel. You see, I'm trying to tell you through that man right there. It's about where you are. Those in, on the web, Periscope. I don't care where you are. The Lord is trying to reach us because he's not willing that anybody perish, but it's coming to an end. The vision that he said is going to happen at an appointed time, and God is trying to get us before he pulls the trigger. God bless you.
We hope you have enjoyed gospel time today. If we can be of any help, please let us know by writing to The Church of God at 4601 South Drexel Boulevard, Chicago, Illinois, 60653, or phone 773-548-7133. If you would like to visit with us, our order of service is as follows. Sunday morning Bible school at 9:15 a.m. Sunday morning worship service, 11 o'clock a.m. Sunday night worship service at 5 p.m. Tuesday night worship service at 7 p.m. Prayer service on Thursday at 12 noon. And Friday night Bible class at 7 p.m. Visit our website and like us on Facebook at churchofgodofchicago.com. Also, join us live on Periscope at COGOC Gospel Time. As we bring this message to a close, we would like to leave these scriptures from the Word of God with you. 1 John chapter 1, verses 5, 6, and 7. This then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light, and as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. The musician for today has been our pianist, Sister Norma Horton. Your reader and announcer has been Sister Alice Allen. May God bless and keep you.
Spirit of unbelief. Will you turn to 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter? Verse 17. I just want to read this. Even now, after hearing all that, the spirit of belief is still working.
Ye therefore.
The Bible says, and here was that the world already, the devil had them. The sinner man, he already had them. We know the devil, we have them. He wants those that trust in God. I mean, he wants those that have lived with God for years. He wants us to be swallowed up with unbelief. Read it, verse 17. What does it say?
Ye therefore, beloved.
And Paul is saying, ye therefore. Peter saying, ye therefore, beloved.
Seeing ye know these
now,
things before.
Now, y'all trying to reach his people. Yeah. Read it for us.
Beware, lest ye also.
And now he said, now I want you to beware. Read it for us.
Being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness.
And God will tell his people, we can't be looking at this world. Amen. We can't fall into this religious world, do all kinds of things, and still saying they're saved, they're lying, they're fornicating, they do all kinds of stuff, and still saying I'm saved. And Peter said, listen, I'm talking to God's people now. Beware. Don't compare yourself to false religion. He said, beware. Lest you be led away with the error of the wicked, you'll fall. You are falling from the stand in one's hand. Because the path was profoundly recently, because sin is an evil work. It's not executed. Speak of God, don't cut you off. As soon as you do that, because people say they have a real good time, they're disobeying God, and they're still prospering. Paul said, you better beware. Beware that you be led away with the error of the wicked. You fall from your own steadfastness. You fall from what your conviction you had.
Let's stand.
The spirit of belief is that all of us. Amen. The spirit of belief will talk to and tell us it don't take all that. Amen. The spirit of God will strive with individuals to show them the need of salvation. And the devil said, listen, you got one of the greatest seven. The devil uses is time. Yes. Amen. It's not to tell you don't get saved, but as the Holy Spirit, but don't do it now. That was a good message, Brother Arnold preached this morning. That was so good. It sounded good, but just don't respond now. And people have come in. We're not trying to scare anybody, but people have come in service like these and left. With attention, I'm going to get right, and death caught me. And they never got a chance. They had intentions. I'm going to do it. But death caught them. And often it's been said, what people have said is so often, hell is filled up with believers. Hell has converted me. It's often been said, saints of God and friends, if God forgives us just a glimpse of hell, just a glimpse to show us people in hell had good intentions. One day I'm going to straighten up, one day I'm going to stop, and one day when they played around and the devil caught them, and he's talking about a revival. If those in hell, but hell's still real, I believe hell's still real. I tell you, it won't be no long walk to God. If God will allow a preacher to just go down there, and I mean, if he just opened the Bible up, to be flooded to the altar, he knows it's real. But unbelievers tell us we got plenty of time. Like Brother said, the Bible says, though it tarry, wait for God. No, God's not slack to turn to the promise. promises. But God, like a God of long suffering, not good. That's a merciful God. God said, I could have cut you off a long time ago. Go to sleep upstairs this morning. We could be in hell a long time ago. But God long suffered with us.
Everybody come to God with God's sake. We don't only come the first time, but God long suffered with us. He pleaded with us. And one day God showed mercy and we saw ourselves and we surrendered to God.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you, I got to pay attention. The brother was pouring out his heart to us. And God's trying to let us know that one day, precious souls, you on social media office here, one day there'll be no more preaching. There'll be no one telling you to get saved. No one telling you to straighten up. Why? Because each one of them gave eternity. And the same God that we rejected in this life, we got to face him. And as the choir gives us a song. Like the brother was saying, the word of God, God want to help us this morning. God trying to help us. You on social media, as God deal with your heart, as God show you himself, will you respond?
Would you
faithful
sing and serve the Lord? Be ready.
The Bible said, know ye not for the long suffering of God for salvation.
The
reason why Jesus have a comeback right now was somebody still needs him. Today is the day of salvation. God said, the day you hear my voice,
not his will. It's not God's will that you long. It's not God's will. It's not God's will. Would you save your soul at any cost? Would you save your soul at any cost? With my soul, God, I know I'm not saved, but God, if you give me grace, Lord, if you help me this morning, is the one that will come. You may be seated.
Amen.
The Bible says, though it tarry, wait for it, because it shall come. Amen, God, for the word of God this morning. We're prepared. We can be surprised how strong the spirit of unbelief is. A former pastor used an illustration with, and he said, we don't use horse fence. He said, a horse, you can lead a herd of horses down a path. And maybe that lead horse might stumble over a rock, a little hole, and hurt his ankle. He said, you can forget about those horses, the rest of the horses are going that way. Oh, but I ain't going there. I saw what happened to him. Of course, we Americans, we humans, though. We see people fall in pit holes, but ain't gonna happen to me. I'm strong. And you just weak. Your mind just weak, man. But I can. They people overdosing. But see, that's he just weak. But made a decision that he see him bad, but also you just weak, man. See. Of course, we're intelligent people, so. But unbelief, the person's soul is a very strong spirit. You love it. God bless you. And thank God for those that are here with us this morning. And at this time, we'd like to.